Alright, we're back. Hey, where do I need to go? Doesn't tell me.
A new day. Another test. I should get back.
Anything I could take here? No? No? Okay. Guess I'll head back then.
Alamut Fortress takes my breath away. As if it leaped out of the hikayat I heard when I was a child.
If you do not have faith in yourself, then who will?
There you are. Are you ready?
I think so.
Put yesterday out of your mind. It has no bearing on today.
Get dressed, and we can begin.
Go on, Basim. Like we practiced.
Yes, Master.
We're climbing? We're climbing too. Up here? Okay.
You look strong today, Basim. Keep training.
Thank you.
Steady, Basim. Steady.
Ha. Leave! Now!
I've seen enough. We will try again tomorrow.
I felt fine.
I can see it in your body. You lose focus too easily. The leap of faith is a crucial step on your path to initiation. It is one of the Brotherhood's first and most sacred rites. To perform it successfully, you must first center your mind, body, and spirit. Embrace the fear. Quiet it. Find the stillness. And let go.
Yes, Master.
Let's return to the camp.
May I ask you something?
You may.
Back in Anbar, at the palace, I witnessed a meeting between the Khalifa and five masked men, order members. The Khalifa was meant to protect the object they discovered, but he knew nothing of their plans for it. He did not even know them by name. How does the most powerful man in Baghdad bend such a fearful knee to the faceless?
The Order has held dominion over such men and their empires for centuries. By convincing them of their truth, that they are the natural arbiters of the world, the Khalifa was but their puppet. And the same will be true of whomever succeeds him. The entire Khalifa is under their influence. Basim, speak with Fulav and see if he needs help. We will continue your training later.
Yes, Master.
Have you seen Mentor Rehan in camp?
He is preparing to receive the Tahari emissary, Master.
Thank you.
Who? Would I find Fulab? Where is he? World map is unavailable.
How is Noor, the brave eagle?
Will he fall, or will he soar?
You will soar, ya Sadiqi. Inshallah.
Thank you. We have a similar spirit, you know.
What gave you that idea?
One of the Banu Musa was angry at you, and you were unfazed. Remember?
I did not touch his hammer.
You refused to apologize for something you did not do. I respect that. Stubborn, like me.
I have been called worse.
Have you seen Fulath?
Have you seen Fulath in camp?
I have seen him speaking to Ahmed near his office.
Araka lahikan.
Upstairs, okay.
I may get back to you on this.
Of course.
Ah, what is this in the corner? Here. A small design.
It is my signature. So you know I created this, and not Al-Hassan, or worse, Abu Jafar. I guess you understand, Wadan.
Ah, Basim, how are you? Yes, Enkidu, food is coming. He is intelligent, and intelligence is supposed to rhyme with patience. Reminds me of someone.
Have you been speaking to Master Roshan?
Have patience. Be kind to your progress.
I will take this to heart. Roshan asked me to come see you?
Ah, yes. Rebecca needs leather strips. Can you fetch those from the storeroom?
I shall, Fulav.
Arakallahekan.
That is not it.
No?
It is hard to find anything in here.
You should remind the bureaus in Baghdad to return to every bloody feather.
No, that is not a strip of leather.
These forces within the Caliphate are beginning to put pressure on us.
Forces? You mean the Order, Rahban?
I can only speak of what I know, Ya Sadiri. The Caliph wishes to nullify the rebels, and if you persist in giving them support, we cannot assure you protection from any Caliphate response.
The rebels supply us with information in Baghdad. Without them, we are blind.
Be that as it may, Governor Muhammad is very committed to showing that he can end this rebellion swiftly.
I do not doubt that.
I came to warn you. Things are moving fast in Baghdad. You may have to act sooner than expected.
I hear you, Aban.
Interesting.
So the Tahirids who govern these lands are the only thing standing between Alamut and a full-scale attack. A fragile peace. How long will it last?
Really?
How does construction go?
It is taking longer than we expected, Yasidi.
That must be frustrating.
Mentor Ryan is a wise man. But he speaks of this mountain as if it was destined that we build here. We have patience and follow his guidance.
Master Roshan tells me I must not be in a hurry to rush back to Madinat as-Salam.
I would not hurry at all. Baghdad is different now. It is very dangerous.
Rebecca?
Basim. Are you just wandering the camp aimlessly now?
No. I have this leather for you. Will it do?
Apparently, you've moved past the wooden sword. I protested, but Roshan insisted. Here is your dagger. And your sword. I am proud to have worked on them.
This blade has character.
Why would I make anything less than unique?
I am in your debt. I was not expecting new weapons today.
Repay me by using it on the Order. Make them feel the sharpness of its character. Roshan said you had further training today. Show her that new sword of yours.
I look forward to it.
Blessings upon you, Basim.
Okay.
How does training go, Yasodiki?
Nor showed me a new way to grip my knife, and it has improved my accuracy greatly. If you throw it just so, it sails through the air, swift and true. Shall I remind you how to use a knife?
Hold G to open the tool wheel. Additional slots. Tool tree. Well, skill trees. Okay. Oh, I was here throwing knives. Ah!
Ya Elahi! Well done! Ah, you have inspired me to train harder.
This is the way, Yasodiki.
Really out of... Oh, okay.
Assalamu alaikum, ya sadiqi.
Wa alaikum assalam. Did Fulab send you?
No, he did not.
You're not here to help move these rocks?
I am quite sure that was not me.
I do not mean to be rude, but I have no time to talk. I must figure this out.
I will leave you to it then.
Okay.
Good work. Until tomorrow. Basim, time for combat training.
I was surprised when Rebecca handed me this. Is a sword not a coarse weapon for a hidden one?
As hidden ones, we must become proficient with a number of weapons. You never know how a fight will escalate. Anyone can wield a sword, but how will you use it?
I am here to learn that, Master.
Are you truly here?
Well, yes. I believe so.
You are here in body, but are you here in mind and soul?
Is this a riddle?
No. It is the difference between life and death. Make sure you target and circle around me. Never turn your back on your opponent. Yes, better. Show me your quick stabs first. Good. Yes. Excellent. There are times when we must put more force into our attack to cause more damage. It will leave you exposed, so time it properly. Now go!
Shift and heavy.
That's it. Come in strong. Excellent. Now, for defense, you can parry the attacks of your opponent. After a few successful parries, your opponent will be stunned. Try to parry my attacks.
All right, use parry. Okay.
Yes. That's good.
Come on.
Excellent. Some attacks cannot be parried and must be dodged instead. Prepare yourself.
Oh, God damn it. Yeah.
Stay out of your head. Ha! Good work. That's the way. Ha! Well done. Now, let us try a free fight together. Use what you've learned.
All right, let's go.
That took me by surprise. Well done.
Stamina has been depleted. It's consumed when dodging or attacking. Now out of stamina, you cannot dodge. Stamina is gradually restored over time or praying or success.
Hey, wake up. Bring your head back to right now.
Take that!
Where did that come from? We are done for today, Basim.
Why must we stop? I learned nothing from failing.
True learning requires action and stillness in equal parts. You have made the action. Now, seek the stillness. Do not rush your training. Be patient. Failure is a part of progress. Think on these words and come back better.
Yes, Master. I will.
Good. See you later.
Ahmed will soon go back to the House of Wisdom. I fear he may end in the middle of a snake's nest.
I know how close you are to your brother. We shall learn more soon. Then we can act.
Assalamu alaikum, Abu Ja'far.
It is Ahmed.
Ahmed, my apologies.
Do not worry. Come and warm yourself by the fire.
Our brother Ahmed is leaving us tomorrow.
To Baghdad, the House of Wisdom.
The House of Wisdom?
We have been working there, my brothers and I, for years. I still have some things to work on. Science waits for no one. And I will fulfill my duty as a hidden one by becoming your eyes and ears among the scholars.
Fulath, tell Basim the story of the feather.
Our tradition of the feather comes from Egypt. They represent the feathers of Ma'at. The feathers of the heron were dipped in the blood of the targets. These would be left for the Lord of the Duat to judge. It is important we remain humble and know our place in the process. We are messengers of justice and not the final judges.
Will anyone help me on patrol tonight?
I will come with you, Noor. I must get my body moving if I'm to warm up tonight.
I am grateful. Let us go. Are you coming, Basim? Leave the stories for later.
I'm coming.
May I speak to you?
You know you can.
I overheard Mentor Rayhan speaking to an emissary earlier.
Mentor Rayhan asked if we may come under attack for dealing with rebels in Baghdad.
Are we safe here at Alamut?
I do not know. But I pity the people who attack this nest of eagles. How goes the watch?
Nothing happening at all on Alamut. And I am so hungry. We did not make it to the main canyon.
Excellent. We will start there. Thank you.
Come, Noor. Follow me.
Going up there? Okay. We are.
Are you looking forward to your initiation?
Yes. It feels like I have been preparing my whole life for this.
I could not sleep the night before my ceremony. From excitement and a small bit of fear, if I am to be honest.
We all fear the unknown. But a greater unknown awaits on the other side of initiation.
You speak of the Order.
I see them as monsters from a tale, hiding in dark corners down dark alleys.
The difference is that the Order is real. This is Mahja.
Magnificent.
Soon, you shall have one of your own.
Fulath introduced me to an eagle named Enkidu. He said we have much in common, and not in a complimentary way.
She sees something. Follow me. Shh. Quietly, Basim. Find a place to hide.
What is this place?
We must be nearing the camp. We have the element of surprise.
Be ready.
Stop making so much noise.
Quickly. I am behind you.
We must strike fast.
Agreed.
Do not make a noise.
What? I'm going to squash you, spider!
Knock his ass out.
Bleed! You are done for! Prepare for hell!
Just die!
Yes! Show no mercy!
There you are!
Do not give up! Keep fighting! Remember your training!
Not like the wooden targets, is it?
It is not that. This sword.
What of it?
Mercenaries from Baghdad use these weapons.
We must warn the others. Mercenaries from Baghdad.
How do you know?
Basim recognized the make of the sword. I believe him.
Bring him in. How do you know these men were from Baghdad?
Growing up on its streets, I have seen their weapons many times. And closely.
Behind every mercenary is a man who gave them their orders.
Yes, and we must act if we are to learn who that is. We will return to Baghdad, seek Ali ibn Muhammad's help.
Ah, of course, Sahib Zanj. He is a dangerous and delusional fool.
Maybe so, but he is one of our only allies in Baghdad. We need him, and we need his men.
I will go back to Baghdad.
Go to Ali. Find out if the order sent those men.
I will.
Wafakak Allah.
Wafakak Allah.
Wada'an. Araka lahiqan.
Alright, so with this, I'm gonna end this episode right here. Like, subscribe, share, and comment if you guys enjoyed. And I'll see you guys in the next episode. Peace out, everybody.